How will the loot box controversy impact the next Borderlands? Well, Randy Pitchford responded on the recent news that every Take-Two game will have recurrent consumer spendings, aka microtransactions.
Be advised, Mental Mars is badass!
Hey, Mental Mars here, and welcome to Borderlands. And if you're new here and as passionate about this game as I am, then please consider subscribing. And with that out of the way, let's dive right into it. So, Randy Pitchford, president of Gearbox Software, responded to a community question about the recent conference call from Take-Two Interactive. And for those who are not in the know, Take-Two is the parent company of 2K Games, which on itself is the publisher of the Borderlands franchise. But in the conference call, Take-Two CEO Strauss Zelnick spoke with investors and made clear that, for at least the Take-Two games, the video game industry is now all about recurrent consumer spendings, rather than game sales. In other words, microtransactions are the way to go. And this raises the question how this business model will affect and translate to the new Borderlands game. Well, Randy himself gave some insight to this by referring to the quote from the conference call. And when he read this, he noticed the Borderlands 1 and 2 DLC model innovated in a way consistent with his thoughts. Because the quote was that it may not always be an online model, it probably won't always be a virtual currency model, but there will be some ability to engage in ongoing basis with our titles after the release across the board. So this basically means that they want to keep you engaged with the game. And this is great news because Gearbox did a good job on supporting Borderlands 1 and 2 with additional content. We just have to wait and see how they innovate on that. So will we be seeing more Headhunter packs and premium cosmetic skins? Only on a frequent base next to the season pass? Personally, I would like to see more Headhunter packs as they provided a nice chunk of gameplay and a cool boss fight. I don't really care about the cosmetic items. Yeah, they look cool, but they are not for me. But I have seen people that go wild on new skins. A noteworthy thing is that Randy left out Borderlands the pre-sequel in his tweet. That would have easily fitted in there with the new 280 character limit on Twitter. Was this a bit of laziness or is it a marketing strategy? Because fans were a bit disappointed in the DLC that game got. But it's hard to follow up on all the amazing stuff they did for Borderlands 2. But business-wise, that was probably a better business model, as the sales from Borderlands the pre-sequel were not as high as Borderlands 2. A little while back, the Lone Vault Wanderer and I did have this idea that the golden keys could be used as a microtransaction. And if you want to see more of this, then check out the iCard above. However, with this tweet from Randy, he suggested that this is not the case, so that's a good thing to hear. But let me know what you guys think of this and what kind of DLC you would like to see. Let me know in the comments below. And with that, I would like to thank you for watching, and if you want to see more videos like this, then use that subscribe button and hit the bell icon so you won't miss anything.